So, if you watched my previous video, you may be aware of the current project that I'm working on, in which, well, I'm basically scratch building a Nurgle army. And when I say scratch building, I mean using regular marines that nobody else wanted, and I adopted like a small orphan. So, what I'm going to do right now is, I just finished putting the wings and basing this, this soon-to-be raptor, which used to be a noise marine, apparently. But, gonna use some handy-dandy green stuff, and I'm going to put a cloak on it. Just to make it a little more ominous. Ominous. Luckily, I've already got some green stuff mixed for that. This may just end up turning into a ramble video, but what I'm going to try to do is do a little how-to as well, if anybody needs one. I don't know. There seems to be quite a few out there. I'll just might as well have my hand at it. Throw in my 2 cents. What we're going to try to do... there's actually several different ways you can do this. I like to just go from scratch and just slap the green stuff on there and work from there. But so there's another way in which you can use wire, thin wire, even paper clips, glue them down and try to get the flow of the cloak, and you just lay the green stuff over it. Not a huge fan of that way. I've only done it once though. I just kind of like a flattening way better. Just try and work out the general shape of the cloak. I'm going to start from the bottom and work my way up. Don't drop your green stuff. Also, a very key feature in working with green stuff is keep everything wet. You got a big cup of water here just for that very purpose. Anything starts to dry out and it's going to be a nightmare. Green stuff's going to start sticking on everything. And it's just going to be a pain. First time I've ever used green stuff. Did not use water. Almost made me cry. Actually, I think I might have bawled myself to sleep. That looks about right. It's gonna cover the base a little bit, but that's alright. Not overly concerned about the base, just really wanna work in the cloak. First, I wasn't quite sure whether I wanted to use a full body cloak or just kinda use a... Yeah, I think I'm actually gonna just wrap it around the bottom. Here's my sculpting tool. It's nothing expensive. Flat iron. I think I got it at Walmart for like $1 in a package of 12. So, don't really need a ton of expensive equipment to get this down. And what I'm going to do now is just kind of working the bottom portion of this cloak around his waist. Now, remember, there's hundreds of different ways you can do this. I'm just working out my way and the way I enjoy it. This is my first time talking to a camera too, so it's kind of weird. Anyway, just kind of, when you get to the waist, just kind of push it down. You take the very tip of it and just kind of push it in. Push the ridges of it of the end, making sure it sticks to the plastic. Try to focus in that, just like that. Just push it down. We'll cover that up with a belt later so you won't see it. We'll put some Nurgle-like stuff on it. Make it look all Nurgle-fied and rotting and disgusting. Uh, There we are. That looks like a pretty good start. Dip my green stuff in some water. Get out another piece and start flattening it out. I'm actually going to stick a hole in... Oh, I was thinking about just putting a... You're going to want to start before you actually put them on. You're going to want to put holes in it first. That way you're not trying to... if you try to put holes in it while it's already on, you're going to end up pulling it off from the waste itself. It just ends up being messy. It's going to cause some problems. You can go ahead and try, but I wouldn't see it just like that. I wouldn't recommend it. Oh, make sure your area is somewhat clean. Unlike mine, I get a lot of crap and particles in the green stuff. It's never a good thing. Just because I drop it on the table so many freaking times that, you'll... plastic pieces stuck in the green stuff, and it just makes it that much worse to work with. Alright. I'm going to bring that more to a point. As you get farther towards the base, you want to start curling up your robe a little bit. That way it's not completely surrounding the base and your base isn't getting... Oh, you know, definitely don't want to go past the base, or else you're going to create inconsistencies in the way the base flattens out on the ground or the table, whatever you're playing on. So that's the bottom of the rope so far. It's not looking too terrible.